Hi everybody, welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to make the first tutorial about microcontroller and electronics. During all this tutorial we are going to use the Arduino microcontroller board, which I have here on my hand. It's specially the Arduino Uno. So what is the microcontroller? Microcontroller is like a computer. It can receive information from pins here, 1 to 13, and it can treat the information based on the program that you transfer in the microcontroller, and then it will send information by these pins. It means that you can make really cool projects, such as, for example, you want to control a solar panel. For example, you can have a sensor of light when there is enough light, so you connect as input on your board. You treat the information to say, okay, I have enough light, then you send after information to your solar panel to say, okay, activate the solar panel because I have enough light. So this is just an example, but you can do so many things. Arduino is also a huge community. It's a free software to program this board. And there is many different components that you can add and do so many different projects with electronics also. I would like also to show you another board, which is a copy, Chinese copy, which is also very powerful. So here we have the microcontroller from the original Arduino Uno. Here it's the microcontroller from the Chinese version, which is a little bit more powerful and smaller, as you can see. We can also have some different, as I say, different version of Arduino board. You can have an evaluate version with Ethernet shield here. So it's the board which you can connect Ethernet here, plus, for example, collect data in SD card, so it's quite interesting depending on which project you want to do. And you can also add some components, so this is three different boards, enfin, this is just the copy and this is another board, but you can also add some motor shield to control, for example, step motor, DC motor. It's very interesting, and you can see that you have already the pins that you can connect on the top of your board. I would like also to show you here, I have one of the smallest board from an Arduino board. It's called Arduino Nano. So you have also the big one, which is Arduino Mega. And this Arduino Nano, it's working with 3.3 volts. Okay. Because usually all these boards are working with 5 volts, and this Arduino Nano is also, you have less pin to set up, so it's very nice, very cool for if you have a little you want to make a little device, so it's very interesting. You can connect also with USB cable, and you have a transistor here to convert to 3.3 volt, which the processor is working with 3.3 volt. For the Arduino Uno, it's the processor is working with microcontroller is working with 5 volt. You can power up by the USB. Okay, so you need an USB, a special USB cable AB male that you connect here. So you can get 5 volt from the computer, or you can also connect by external battery, and you can connect from 7 volt to 12 volt. You can also go higher, but it's not required, but you can go higher because this transistor here can accept more. It can accept also 15 volt. So how it's working, you need to have a computer with you. So here I have my MacBook Pro. You need to connect the board with the USB cable, and then you need to send your program to the microcontrollers. But to do this, so you need to write with the software your program, and then you need to compile this program to a machine language, which is a series of 1 and 0. The 1 and 0 program, the language will come by the USB port. It will be then transformed by this component here, the square here, to be reading by the microcontroller and to do the job. When you power up the board, the microcontroller will check first if there is any program sent by yourself, and if there is nothing, it will run the oldest the program which was already inside. However, if you send something, then it will erase and upload your program. There is also TX and RX, which mean transmission and reception of information. So you can also plug here, you can connect here, and then you can read what's happening on the board. And just to finish, few words about this microcontroller. So as I say, it's like a computer, receive the information, treat the information, and send information. He has to do this different kind of memory, the flash memory, which will have, which is where your program is stored. You have the RAM, SRAM, where is only the memory. It's like a temporary memory only when the board is powered up. You have the EEPROM, which corresponds, if you compare to the computer, to the hard disk. And you have this memory called MDR, which is the memory data register. It's the memory of the CPU. It's the memory of the processor inside the microcontroller. And finally, there is this cache memory. This cache memory makes the link between this MDR and the RAM. So I'm done now for the explanation, and I would like to show you in the second part now of this first tutorial how to connect, how to install the program, and then to make our first program. So you need the cable, as I say. You connect here the board, and then you plug it. It's a little bit. And then you plug on your computer like this. So I don't know if you can see, I will move a little bit the light. Then yes, you have this green light, which I don't know, I can focus. Okay, super. Cannot focus anymore. Yes, no, I should be closer. Yeah, so you have the green light, which show that the board is power on. Okay. So now I cannot make focus anymore. Yes, sorry. Okay, so now let's go to the computer. We go to Google Chrome. This is Google Chrome. To Google, then you write arduino.cc. Enter. Then you arrive to the original the original website of the Arduino board, and then you go to software. So now you have to download software. As I say, it's free. We get the last version, the 1.8.5. And what is also cool, I didn't mention, you can use different environment. You can use Windows, macOS, but also Linux. So it's very interesting that you are not restricted by the environment of your computer. So for me, I will use macOS 6 because I'm using right now MacBook Pro. You have, so you can contribute here by giving some money to this project, or you can just download. So if you click, a message will pop up and say, do you want to download? You say yes, and then I put it here, you get this folder. So let's do it now. You double click, everything is unzip right now. Okay, and now you have directly the program. You just have to drag your so let's go to application folder and you drag and drop, and that's it. It's installed. Double click on the Arduino icon. Some verification. You say open. Okay. Takes a little bit of time doing in the same time with you. Then that's it. You have this window where you can write your program. So let's talk a little bit about the program. There is two parts of the program. The first part is the voice setup, where you will, as is written, set up the program. And you have the void loop, which is where you will write your program, and you will also put some variable. So we call local variable. You will define a local variable. So here it's the program location, and the voice setup, it's where you set up your program. And before all these two compartments, you have to define here global variable. Okay, you can define before this global variable. So let's start. You to make the program before to make the program. So now we connect the board to the computer. We have to say to the program which board we are using. So you go to Tool, Board, and then you select, sorry, Arduino Uno. You can see that you have many different boards, and you have this Arduino Nano I present just before, and I talk also about Arduino Mega, which is the big board that somebody use also, people use to make 3D printer. So you can make 3D printer with Arduino Mega. There is some tutorial also. So when you finish, you select your board, and after you have to select which board are you using, where is connected your microcontroller board. So here I select, it's here, but for I know that for Windows you will have COM, so different COM 3, 4, 5. It's the port COM of your USB. To know which port your board is connected, you just have to disconnect it, and you will hear the ding dong, meaning that something happened, that the board is removed, and you just have to, when you do it, you just have to check which COM disappear. If it's the COM3, then it means that your board is connected to the COM3. So let's start. For the first tutorial, we would like to make the blinking LED, but the blinking LED inside the board. So there is an inside circuit, a LED, where there is a resistance, and they use the 5 volt of the board, so the LED is already integrated. This LED is...
It's 19 hours.
Thank you. This LED is drive by the pin 13. So we can write... So first, in the voice setup, as I say, you have to set up your program. So you write, you have to make pin mode. So usually in programmation, when you have two words, it depends, but it's sometimes people make like small characters and capital letter here to separate. You can also make, but this is the command, so you cannot change. But usually when you make variable, it's like this. So just to tell you this. So you have pin mode. Pin mode means that you will say, okay, I would like to activate, so open bracket, the pin 13, okay? And now you activate it. You say, okay, activate pin 13 and define it as I told you, input or output. In our case, we would like to put 5 volt to the LED. So we like to define as output, and it's in capital. You see, when you don't write properly, it's not the right color. You can see that it color to show you that you the command, the syntax is good. Close the bracket, and when you finish a command, you always make a semicolon. Then the line is finished. So here we can add some comment. So to make a comment that it will not be read by the program, you have to make double slash, and then you say that declare. We can say that we activate pin 13, okay, and define as output. Okay. Now we go in the void loop. Now where we have to make the program, and we would like to send 5 volt. To send 5 volt to the pin, to the LEDs by the pin, you have to make call digital capital, right? As I said, when two world is like this. So it's just to remember when you don't know pin mode, it is capital letter for M or digital right, then you know that usually it's like this. For this kind of program language. The same, open bracket. Inside the bracket, now, so let's remove the space, it's not necessary. Let's make always the same. Digital write, so you want to write on pin 13 something. You want to give 5 volt. So when you make, where so you activate pin 13, you make it as output, and now you select you say that pin 13 is digital write. Digital write means that you will send 5 volt or 0 volt. It means that you have signal which is high or low. High 5 volt, low 0 volt. So here I would like to send 5 volt. So you have two possibilities. It's binar, hein? Like interrupter. So you say high, and don't forget, you close by semicolon. Okay, so here it means that if I send this now to my board, the LED from the board will be activate, and they will, and you will see the light. Okay, let's go. So as I said before, you have your language, which is close to C, C++. Now we are talking to the board, and to talk to the board, we need to compile to get the machine language. So you have to press here, compiling. Now the compiling is done, and you have to upload to your board. Press upload, uploading, and then you see here, I don't know, you see, now, I don't know, I can focus. Maybe too close. But you can see that there is a light. The light came. Okay. Now I would like to make a blinking light. Okay. So to blink the light, you need to turn it on, turn it off, turn it on, turn it off. The program is written on the loop. It means that when he read it like this, he's finishing to read and is going back here. Is finishing, going back. So you have this loop. It means that I would like to activate, so put it on with high, and now I would like to put it down, so low, with 0 volt. I would like to put no tension anymore. So 0 volt. Digital write. So I'm writing on the pin 13. Now, low. But it's cool, but the problem now is we want to make something blinking, meaning that you have a time that the pin is high, so it means that there is 5 volt, there is a light, and the time that the LED is dark, it means that there is no light. So you have to make a delay between these two commands. And how you write the delay command function, so it's delay, simply like this. And the delay is always defined in milliseconds. As to remind you, 1 second corresponds to 1,000 milliseconds. I would like to blink the LED half second. It means that I should write 500 here. So we can put some comment. So why is also important to put some comment in your program? First of all, it's for yourself. Imagine now you do some program and after 1 month you come back and you don't remember how you did it. So it's nice for yourself. It's nice also to better understand what you are doing and also to come back to your project. But it's also interesting when you work with other people that you share a program to in the group that you make a project that other people can understand what you have done. So here we say, okay, I have a delay of 500 milliseconds. Okay, we can also put some information ici, here that the pin 13 is on. Okay, so 5 volt here, pin 13 is off, 0 volt, sorry, 0 volt. Okay, as I told you, it's a loop. It means that it will be high, delay of half second, then it will be off, and then it's coming back. It means that you also need to make a delay after the LED is off. So let's put a delay with 500 like this milliseconds. Okay, let's compile and upload. And now you see the LED is blinking. Okay, now just to finish, in the language of programmation, you should never put, and for any language, it's better to never put numbers inside your program. You always have to work with variables, and you have to define, I told you before, that before these two parts, you have to make global variable. Sorry. Alors, we define global variable, which is here an entire number, 13, which is LED. Let's put LED on board equal to 13. So here I define a global variable which is entire, okay, equal to 13. Then you have to remove here LED on board. Just command C, command V, command V. And then here you start to have some program which is more clear. And also what is nice is, for example, now I would like to also put the delay as a variable. So we call it, for example, time. So some variable cannot be used. For example, here when I write time, it consider as a function of time, but it's not good. So you should never use the function of the program as a variable. So time cannot be used. So you can make time delay. You can see that is not taken by the program. Equal 500. And now you take this, Control C, and you replace here. Control V, Control V. Why is nice to do this also is, for example, now imagine you want to change the delay. It's more easy to change here the variable than to go each part of your program here. It's okay, you have like four lines, but imagine now you have many lines, you have to check where is it. So if you define variable, it's more easy for you and also more easy to read your program. You verify, done compiling, and then you upload. And you should have the same result. As you can see, the LED is blinking. So this is the end of the first tutorial. We will go next step to go a little bit deeper in this language programmation. So thank you for your attention, and see you next time for the tutorial number 2. Ciao.